Amen.
God's been good to me.
Yay. Oh, yes, he has. Yes, he has. Glory to God. Father, in the name of your son, Jesus, you've been good to us. We've come together to bless your name. We recognize you today. We know that you're God, and besides you, there is no other. Now we stand on the promises of your precious word. We thank you because you're God. Now let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our heart be acceptable in your sight, for you are indeed our God, our strength, and our Redeemer. In Jesus' name, amen. And amen. God bless your heart. You can be seated. I had something, and I think I left it upstairs. My Sunday school book. You have yours, sir? Yeah, this is a youth. It might be the same. I don't know. Man, it's so nice not having glasses. You just walk around and see. I just need them to read. No, I need to, yeah, the adult. Here you go, baby. I don't need to exercise, yeah. Yeah, the workbook is good, but this is, what's that, baby? The senior high, yeah. Look at my wife. Well, she came right with the book. Oh, the book, the book. Give me the book. Give me the book. No, this is all good. Thank you. Amen. Yeah, man. That's it. This is what I needed. Thank you. I want to read something. Man, I've been, before I get started, which I got a lot of reading. Oh, my God, I was reading this morning. I got a lot of reading. So, but I want to read this. This is in Sunday school. All those that attended Sunday school, stand on your feet. Everybody that was in Sunday school, stand on your feet. Let me take my glasses off. Hey, they're my young people. I salute you. I salute you. Look at, I was here, but yeah, I was here. Yeah, you was here. Yeah, you was here. You know, you was here. You was here at 8 o'clock, so you were here. This Sunday school lesson was just, I've been in church over 40 years of my life. And this really leaped out at me. I want to read this to y'all. It says, in addition to the sign of circumcision, which was last week's lesson, which they have already studied, God gave his people a sign of the Sabbath. And we know that Sabbath is seventh, but and my class asked me about the first day of the week, and I gave it to them out of the book of 1 Corinthians 16th chapter and the book of Acts. And it talks about the first day of the week. But here's what it says. They were to set one day aside each week for the express purpose of meeting with God. He had blessed them. By meeting together weekly, they would be reminded as an entire nation of that blessing. We can understand why our nation is going, there's a word, but I'm not going to say it, in a basket, but I'm not going to go there. Yeah, because we, you know, Aunt Mamie, will you stand? Cynthia said something. Where's Aunt Mamie at? She here? I thought I saw, where's she at? There you are, baby, yeah. Aunt Mamie was sharing with my wife. They had a 66-day revival. 66 days. And maybe had her children with her at the time. During the SEPTA strike, she was there 63 of the 66 days. Now, she said they had to walk. How long did it take y'all and maybe to get to the church and back? If we had a 66-day revival, first of all, I'm missing 95% of y'all. You can be seated. And if you had to walk an hour and a half, bingo, Pastor might not be here. Pastor might not be making it. Now, you can see why she's so blessed, why her family's blessed. Do you know if you recognize God, he recognizes you? I told the church that. You recognize him. You know, and we, there's a verse of scripture where God said, I am a jealous God. I'm jealous. And I asked him, can God be jealous? Yeah, he can be. Yeah, he's jealous. And the reason why God is jealous, because you don't recognize. You don't recognize. I told you, I was sharing with our class, if you have a person that you think should recognize and they don't recognize you, you're jealous. Now, if my wife, I got my wife and she hanging out with whoever. That's why even with my grandkids, sometimes I get jealous. Hey, what's your world? I get first place. I want the first plate, the first hot dog out the pot. Amen. My mom's sitting right here. Even here I am at 66 years old. I can still see her going to, she had finished the meal, she would get this special plate. And she would fill that plate up like she was feeding an army. I mean a group. Fill that plate up, and she would take that plate and set it aside, cover it up. My dad knew that he wasn't there, but the first plate that was fixed went to my dad. And that plate stayed there until Daddy got home. Now, we had dibs on what Dad left, but and we'd argue, you had it yesterday. He knew he wasn't going to eat it all, and he watched us fight over it. But Mom, look, and here we are today. Oh, God help. That's, y'all wonder why brothers get jawed up, ladies. If I saw my wife does take care of me, I ain't messing with you, baby. You know the deal. But you know the deal. Y'all know the deal. Now, some brothers may not get a plate, but that's okay. We were talking in reference to the Holy Ghost, and we were moving it on. And God was really dealing with me over this course of just dealing with this lesson. He took me to the book of Romans. Turn your Bibles, if you will. Now, I'm reading out of the NIV because the NIV literally broke this thing down to a level where when I read it, it makes more clarity. Not sense, just clarity. You know what? Before I go there, put a marker there. I got to go to the book of Corinthians, the 14th chapter. I preached this message and I said, 1 Corinthians. Thank you. I was talking out of the book of a matter of fact, I was talking about tongues. And primarily, the reason why I was expressing tongues, because, first of all, a lot of it's back in the time that we pushed it, and if you've been in certain denominational groupings, Assemblies of God, Church of God, Church of God in Christ, most Pentecostal churches, we literally banked our Holy Ghost experience on speaking in tongues. If you did not speak in tongues and you were in one of our circles, we said you didn't have it. How many remember that? Anybody here? Raise your hand if you know what I'm talking. Most of us today, why I can go to where I'm going is definitely good. But back then, if you did not get up on the altar, come up here, after you got saved, and we're not really realizing the fact that God, the Holy Spirit, had to save you. He's the one who God designated to you to get you here, to get you where you're sitting now. You got to understand, God favors you. Oh, my God, I can't say that hard enough. There's something about you that God favors. And the more you understand that, the more you see his favor. How many of y'all saw his favor this week? Amen. My God, something was happening, and the favor of God wasn't just a blessing. It wasn't just a blessing. It was a favor. Hail glory to God. God favored us. Well, we wanted to hear you. We had to hear you say something out of your mouth. And like I said, now, you know, we're at a phase you can say Hibachi Grill, you can say Toyota, Kawasaki, you know, and we'd be halfway okay. But back then, we had to tarry and hear you speak in tongues. Well, the reason for that is because if you go into the book of Acts, the second chapter, or first into the second chapter, it gave us as an evidence that you have the Holy Ghost. But as I progressed in my saved life, I found out it's not just tongues. It's far more than that. It's the power and the anointing of God that shows the evidence of the Holy Ghost. Some of you, some of us, you and us, you and I would be dead and gone if it wasn't for the Holy Ghost leading and directing. Oh, God, thank you for the Holy Ghost and realizing the power of God. Oh, I can't say that enough because I would not be where I am today if it wasn't for God's Holy Spirit. The footsteps of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord. Even in our uniquenesses, the Holy Ghost. Well, we're going to read. I'm going to go into the 14th chapter. It says, and this is why I'm going where I'm going. Follow the way of love. This is the NIV. Do you have it, Crystal? You don't have the NIV, do you? All you got is the King James. My God, you got to update that. Put that. Jesus. You don't have nothing else other than that? Let me take my glasses off so I can see you. That's all you got. Check. Check. The reason why I'm doing that because the NIV brings a clarity. Now, I'm a King James man. I cut my teeth. Matter of fact, I'm going to. Why do they call it the King James Bible? Yeah, because I love you, Holy Spirit. Why do they call it the King James Bible? Oh, Jesus. God bless us. Dot. Why did they call it? Because I only reason I called you because you look down. If you had to look, why did they call it the King James Bible? I love it. Why did they call it King James, baby? He wrote it. He wrote. How much? Who else? Who else? Are you ready for this? He authorized. If you read it, what happened? God bless us. This is Bible study time. And you're right, Cheryl, you're right. He didn't write it. He authorized because at that time, the Catholic Church was the only authorization. And if you did any translation of the Bible other than under the unction of the Pope, they killed you. Wow. Wycliffe, I can't think of his first name. Tisdale. You hear these great names? These men died for translating this word so we could get it. Oh, my God, I better read this Bible. Look, men died. The blood was shed so we could read this. So we could read it. The Catholic Church said, you ain't reading no Bible. There ain't enough God in you. You ain't got the Holy Ghost. So only the priest could read it. And as a matter of fact, if you go all the way back when they first started writing the Bible, they would write, when they got to the word Elohim or God, they would use that pen and throw it away. They wouldn't use it again. Because they honored God. Oh, my God, I feel like preaching this thing. They had a respect for God. They take that pen and write Elohim, and we ain't going to use that again because we honor him. He's first, and that's the first pen, and that's the last we're going to use. And when they went to his name again, they wrote it, throw it away. But it was the authorized King James. He authorized individuals to translate this from the Vulgate and so forth and so on, and so we got it. Matter of fact, if you ever look at it, it says the authorized King James Version, because he did it. He told the Pope, forget you. We're going to do this. But, okay, so look at what it says. Follow the way of love. You got a crystal. My God. You got it. Here, take my phone. No, I'm just kidding, baby. Okay. Follow the way of love and eagerly desire spiritual gifts, especially the gift of prophecy. For anyone who speaks in a tongue does not speak to men but to God. Indeed, no one understands him. I just spoke tongues. Be like God. It just comes right out of me because I have the gift of tongues. But I need somebody to interpret that. Elder Alexander, it's on you. That's right. The reason why the Bible said prophesy, because when you read that word, if you stand up and say, thus saith the Lord, glory to God that I love you. And now, let me share something with you. The reason why we had prophets of old is because they didn't have the book. They didn't have the Bible. So he had to be the book. Jeremiah was a prophet that God spoke to tell them, if you don't do this, this is going to happen. And did it happen? Oh, you better believe it. Elijah, Isaiah, Ezekiel, they were the written, they were the God-written book given to you. Now, every time I read this word, I'm prophesying because it's closure. God, help me. If you read the book of Revelations, Revelations bring closure. Everything that God wants us to know, he's to put it in the book. Now, I can stand up here and say, okay, I want to prophesy. Deacon, 5 days from now, you're going to have $5,000 sent to you, email. No, <I'm just> Now, are y'all ready for this? You know, how many of you ever rode by and saw a spiritualist hand reader or Talmud cards or whatever? Any of y'all ever read your horoscope? Any horoscope readers in here? Anybody under the sign? How many of y'all know your sign? What's your sign? I know my sign. Know my sign? I sign. Sign. Now. Well, first of all, I'm going to share something with you. None of that's of God. God is not under no sign. I'm a Sagittarius. And here's what you do. Here's what you do. You start soothsaying. Sagittarius are, well, what's my sign? I'm September. Somebody help me. I'm September. I don't know what. When am I? Libra. Okay, Libra. A Libra. Now, what they've done, they studied Libras or what they've read. And a Libra acts like this. And this is what he's going, that's why, baby, that's why he's acting like that, because he's a Libra. I know, you. What are you? You can't mix with a Libra. How many of you ever told somebody you can't mix because of your signs? How many? Yeah. You know the deal. Matter of fact, most folk believe the signs more than they believe the word. That's right. They don't believe the word. Ain't no faith in the word, but they faith in that sign. Baby, I'm going to tell you, you should have threw him away 5 years ago because the sign. You can go to the newspaper. You can go, matter of fact, on your phone. Where's my horoscope? And read it every morning. And I'm going to tell you something. That is not prophesying. That's a spirit. It is a spirit because that spirit will lock you in. And it will prevent you from hearing, oh my God, I'm preaching this. It'll prevent you from hearing the word of God. It prevents you from hearing, glory to God, the Holy Ghost in your life. Because you would rather hear that first than hear God first. Oh my God, I preach this thing. Look, so I desire that you prophesy. That means you share the word. I'm prophesying to you right now. But then there's levels of prophecy. I can go into another level. Oh, God, help me in this house. Look, so, indeed, no one understands him. He utters mysteries with his spirit. That's why going to God, ask God to give you tongues. Because you'll be in a fix, and you'll start praying in tongues, and God will help you. It ain't going to help y'all, but it'll help me. How many of you ever said, Lord, I need help? It's not my mother, not my father, but it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. I need you now. I need you. I need you. Because if you don't, you won't keep praying. You'll go into a self-pity party. The devil will bombard your head. Let me tell you something. Your mind is open territory as long as God is not in it. Direct the Holy Spirit. I'm going to use the word. The Holy Spirit's job is to take and renew your mind. So you can stop acting like you're acting. Locked in stupid. Amen. Locked in stuff that happened years ago. Just locked. Hating food. That ain't nothing but a trick of the devil, that color barrier. Black, white, different. Oh, my God, help me in the house. That's how come you can't minister love because you're locked in uniqueness. Years. I know where I got it from. I was taught it as a boy, going to God. If a man was gay, I was taught to dislike him. Like him. Don't touch me. A woman. I could tolerate a lesbian more than I could tolerate a gay guy. Lesbian, at least I can look at her one other way. Okay. But because of that, I could not minister love. Because I ain't like you. I was taught not to like people because of their color. The Holy Ghost said, oh my God, help me. I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. But be not conformed to this world, but be by the renewing of your mind, by the renewing. And the only way you're going to get that is the word through the Holy Ghost. That's why people that are not saved cannot read this book. They can read it, but they cannot read it. Because it takes the Holy Ghost to do this. That's why he's sent. Leading God you into all truth and righteousness, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. But everyone who prophesies does what? Speak to men for their strengthening, encouragement, and comfort. And he who, you got it, Crystal? My God, that girl's sharp. You are sharp. Crystal, I heard them reading, and I thought they had went to their phones. You are no joke. God bless your heart. Girl, you got your job forever. Even with the mummers up in heaven, you're going to be doing this. And he who speaks in tongues does what? Edifies who? But he who prophesied does what? Edifies what? The church. The church. That's how come, I'm going to say this, and I can understand why we needed endorsement, because back then, we wanted you sure enough saved. Look at somebody said, we wanted you sure enough saved. Oh, we wanted you saved. Oh, you go, if you, young ladies, you got pregnant out of wedlock, we'd pull you up front. Oh, back then they pulled you up front, threw stones at you, killed you. Thank God all we did was just talk about you. Men, we didn't, but you know, back then there was more of a accountability. And slowly but surely, accountability began to drift because the Holy Ghost was not recognized in sanctification. Sanctification is, that's when you start turning over. See, when you get saved, God comes in. He's really in the foyer. You know, he's just right there in the foyer. He's okay, and then he said, let me come on in. You've got ways. Okay, I'm going to let you in the living room. You let him in the living room because you clean it up. You're trying to clean up the living room. But there ain't no bedroom visitation. And the Lord knows you ain't going in the kitchen. You ain't going in the kitchen. Those are areas in your life that you have not let him in to control. How many ever heard of a stronghold? Stronghold is an area where the devil has a right to set up in your life. He has a right because what has happened, you've given him a right. If you allow the devil a right, I hate this. When you say hate, he sets up in there and he'll set up in there. And you saved, but he's locked in that room. And he said, oh no, I ain't giving up this territory. Right. Locked in your head. Amen. And he loves going in the area. Oh God, help a sexual area, addiction area. Man, he gets up in there and he just, oh, he's like this. And somebody start preaching against you, get mad. Yeah. Who are you talking about? Then you start talking about them. Who do you think they are? I'm just as holy as they are. Of false. Why? Because the devil is the accuser of the brother. Now, my God, if you knew word, you'd know that. So now I'm beginning to see, oh, I want God, I want you in the closet. I don't just want you in the living room, the kitchen. I want you all throughout. Matter of fact, take the keys to it all. Take the keys. I've learned, and I'm going to tell you this. We was with Ida Terry on Friday. Excellent meeting. It was talking about with depression. 99% of the church is depressed. The world is depressed. How many know the world is depressed? Matter of fact, you look at the news is devised to depress you. How many know that be the case? Matter of fact, the news will draw you to it through depression. You're like, oh my God. Those, God bless our hearts, those meteorologists, CNN, different ones, they're standing out there in the rain. I think it was a fan blowing. He out there like this. The winds are terrible. I don't even know how I'm standing. I'm like, are you kidding me? And so we're looking at it like, oh, Jesus, nobody's going to make it. I called out to Florida. I didn't even lose power. I'm like, the way that wind was blowing. And that joker standing there in the rain, beating him all in the face. Do you know, God bless our hearts. I said, Lord, after this, I'm done. Yeah. So, now you understand tongues. You need it. Now, let's go to the book of the 12th chapter of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians. It says, now about spiritual gifts. Crystal, you have it, babe. Yeah. 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter. Yeah, boy, she blew that thing up. My God. No, you're still playing with it, but it just leaped at me like, wow. Yeah, I like that big print. Now about spiritual gifts, brothers. I do not want you to be ignorant. You know that when you were unsaved, pagans, somehow or another you were influenced and led astray with mute idols. Now, this isn't a beat up, please. Don't get me wrong. I'm just giving you. You ever notice? Now, back in the day, we were nasty when we danced. Slow drags was nasty. I don't care what anybody said, it was a nasty dance. Slow drag, we did the dog. We did the mashed potatoes. Huh? The slop. How many of the slop? The bop was decent. The bop had a little something to it. The slop. That means slop. Twist. Now, they downright indignant. Y'all are just nasty. How many say nasty? Young lady got her butt all up in the guy. And are you serious? No, seriously. I'm serious. Take the shirt off. Guys dancing with no shirt on. The girl half dressed. Butt all up in his, you know. They all on the floor, one leg. I'm like, what in the world? Hey! Now you say, Pastor, how in the world you see? I'm like, I can't look at nothing. Soul Train, gone. At least they went down the aisle doing something. You know, now they're all on the floor. Yes, sir. Oh, yes, sir. Jesus. As a born-again believer, I dare you. I dare you. I dare you as a born-again believer. I dare you. Guy all up riding on your back like a camel or something. That's embarrassing to God. Not just to me, it's embarrassing to your mom and dad. Am I talking right? Come on. The Holy Ghost is telling you, don't do it. That's embarrassing. Who are you impressing? Oh, no, they don't, brother. Oh, man, my God, brother. Deke working it now. Deke said, I'm going to prophesy. Yeah. And nothing worse than a person my age trying. Now, let me leave that alone. Just leave that alone. Leave it alone. I just had to throw that out, young people, because we don't do that. I don't care what you say. Pastor, we can't have no fun. If that's fun, then heaven don't belong to you. I'm talking right, man. We got to start. Come on. No, we can't. We got to stop embarrassing God. We saved Sunday and going out into the world just embarrassing God. Oh. You know, you need to say, Holy Ghost, help me to stop embarrassing God. It ain't about the pastor or the church. It's God I got to. Look. See, talking about, you know that when you were pagans, somehow or another, you were influenced to be led aside with the idols. Okay, therefore I tell you that no one who is speaking by the Spirit, the Holy Ghost of God, says, Jesus, huh? Be cursed. You can't be God damn everything. And you talk about, oh, but I love Jesus. He's my Savior. Oh, y'all get with me. We can't be just blaspheming and think we okay. Lord, y'all smack me in my mouth. You hear me talking curse? Just walk up and smack my face. You tired joker. No. Hey! Hey! Look, Jesus, except by the Holy Ghost, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost, take control of my mouth. How many just stop talking junk, talking about everybody? Help me, Holy Ghost. Help me. Even in my texting fingers. Take control of these fingers. Help this mind. There is no difference. There are different kinds of gifts, but the same Spirit. Here's where we go. There are different kinds of service, but the same Lord. Evangelist Evans and her crew can't go in that kitchen, cut up them biscuits and stuff and do what they do, except God. Because there's times you want to smack somebody. Ushering. You get mad ushering folk today. Amen. Security. They sitting back there smiling, but they good. No, I'm serious. Whenever you start working in God's service, the devil says, I can mess this up. That's why it takes the Holy Ghost. And that's why you have to come and pray before God. Lord, I'm getting ready to go into service right now. Matter of fact, that's why Evangelist Evans have y'all in that kitchen. God, in the name of Jesus, help us. Holy Ghost, have your way. And see, you got to do that in order for God. Matter of fact, you got to do that, Lord. I just pulled up at Walmart. Holy Ghost, rebuke the devourer for my sake. Oh, my God, I'm preaching. Somebody write this down. Rebuke the devourer for my sake. You know I'm just in here to buy butter and eggs? Yeah. Maybe a box of flour. That's about it. Lord, Father, in the name of Jesus. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. I feel like preaching, man. You pull up the KGs. Father, in the name of Jesus. Just in here for a shirt and tie. I ain't in here for buy one, get one free. Help me. In the name of Jesus. Oh, my God, I feel like preaching. Oh, God, I feel like preaching. Young folk. Lord, I'm about ready to take this test. You know I ain't studied. You know. Holy Ghost. Help me stop being disobedient. But I need favor right now. I need grace. Oh, my God. Everything you do, just, Lord, I'm getting behind this wheel. I'm about ready to drive down this crazy 55 in the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, take control of this wheel. Help me. Oh, my God, I feel like preaching. Hey! Now. There are different kinds of workings, but the same God working all of them and all my God want to use me. Somebody said, God want to use me. God want to use me. My God, do you know the paycheck that God, y'all better look out in this house when God pays you? Oh, life becomes sweeter. He gives you money going. He gives you the stuff that God gives, money cannot buy. All hell breaking loose, and all of a sudden you're walking around with peace. You walk around, my God, I'm on this job and God and gave me peace. You ever been in a situation and you're driving and all of a sudden the dividends of God will come over you and you just say, feel happy. I'm just happy and I know it. I can say amen. I'm a God, I'm happy and I know it. Oh man, I didn't even punch my time. Y'all bear with me. Where am I? I gotta be done. As much as I want to go in and just eat this thing up and just rip it apart and just go to a level where, okay, no. Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. Do you know the Holy Ghost is looking? He's in your life and saying, I want to use you in this. I want to elevate you. And see, we get mad because somebody can sing better. That ain't your gift. Man, get off. You can't play it. You can't play either, but he anointed. I'm not. I'm mad. Who died and left you both? My God, if I had a dime for every one of y'all to say, who died and left Pastor Balls? Here you go again. Nobody knows.
That's right.
I told the young people this morning, told them. I said, do you think, by any stretch of your imagination, I just came up with this brilliant analogy. Come to Sunday school. I didn't come up with that. Because I'm going to tell you what, Cynthia got up and she's stirring. I'm like, oh, Jesus, here she is up early. She's stirring around. What shirt you going to wear? Whatever you give me, I'll wear it. I don't matter. I'll wear a T-shirt. So I'm laying on that pillow, and Sunday mornings, it's like, oh, the pillow be saying, stay, Jimmy, and it fluffs up. It's like, poof. Oh, man. How many, anybody know what I'm talking about? Oh, it's such a mom. I've got my pillow and I'm sweating, my God. And now I'm thinking, okay, I got to get up. I ain't even thinking about who's showing up. I got to get up. I get up. I'm saying, this is the only day I can kind of kick. And you ever notice Sunday morning is the only day you can kind of kick back? Yeah. I'm coming out here at 8 o'clock. And I go, I'm thinking, okay, here's L. Alexander in the corner. And I got to see them and they're going to be praying. They're going to see me late if I show up late. Dignus Gaines now is beating everybody here like she's special. You know, like she's got special privileges. I'm going to see the Lord first. I'm like, okay. There's evangelists there. So I pull up here and I see their cars. Oh, Jesus. They're here first. They're first. Oh, okay, that's good. I get here and I'm going through. Now think about what I'm saying. Do you think that's like, whoa, I'm going to church. I'm going to church. Good. There's times that you don't feel like going. But I know. Oh, I done been around too long. Hey, I know that when the pressure comes, there's something going on. Lord, open my eyes. I feel like Elijah talking to Gehazi. Look at, oh, Lord, open his eyes. Man, the angels are step. My God, do y'all know? It ain't the sign time that we have. God have angels standing. Even though we open the doors, they escort. Because do you understand that this day is set aside for God? For a God. This ain't set aside for us. is set aside so I can come and recognize God. I don't see him physically, but I know it. Oh my God, dude. L. Alexander. Look, when I walk down those aisles, it's like I'm walking into the actual presence. Oh, church, y'all better act like you know. Look, you're going there and he's sitting on the throne saying, well done, my good and faithful servant. Come on. What is it? What do you want? Now I'm going to bite you right now. Somebody say, bite us. Narrow is the way. Narrow is the way that leadeth to life. And there are few that travel thereon. So I'm like, okay. Now I can better understand. All of y'all don't feel like doing it. A lot of y'all feel like I'm going to just do what I do. But I got to get on that narrow. I'm like, I got to stop looking at the crowd and being all overwhelmed by y'all not wanting to do. I got to keep walking. Oh, y'all hear me? My God. I got to keep walking. I can't let nothing going to hinder me. I don't care. Well, you do what you do. You do you. I'm going to do me. I'm going to just, oh, because I know. Achajayay. Man, if I can give y'all this away, it's tearing me up on the inside. It's time. I'm at my hematologist oncologist on Wednesday. I feel great. Little pains and aches every, you know, and they come. But they've been tracking me, and my numbers are elevating it like this. So he looks at me and says, he said, how you feel? I said, feel great. He said, we got to give you another bone scan because there's something. I'm saying to myself, hey, if it's something, I don't know it. I feel great. See, now here's where the world, I got to separate. You better listen. That's when you know you got to get tight because, see, now they're trying to make you. So he tells me, he said, I'm going to get you into your 70s. I'm going to get you into your 70s. Like, what are you trying? I feel pretty good. I feel like, oh, well. But here's the thing that got me. It was the fact that if God called me right now, y'all, oh my God. If God said, come on home, son. See, first of all, the closer you get to him, the closer he gets to you. After a while, he starts putting something in you. Who knows what I'm talking about? He starts putting something in you. It's like, oh my God. You don't fear death. You don't fear. It's like, now, young people, I understand y'all. Y'all going to go through the same stuff we went through. You'll get married to somebody. Pray God it works good. That's why you got to get close. Pray God. Because marriage is not the fix-all. You get some people, glory to God, and they come in with a U-Haul truck. Beep, so much stuff. Beep, 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 backing up. Beep, 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 beep. You know the fix-all? Jesus. Jesus. When you walk down that aisle, know that that person loved the Lord. I mean, know they love the Lord. Do the best you can with what you got. Yeah, glory to God. But then what he does, he starts directing your life. Come hell and high water. And I've seen hell and I've seen high water. But he's still directing my life. But after a while, you start seeing the dust settle. You start looking and saying, wow, yeah, man. So now I know. Church, I know more than I've ever known. He's real. I know he's real. I know he hears me when I pray. I know when he sends me people, I pray for him. I know he's going to do something. Jesus. I know he's going to do something. I know it. I don't think it. I know it. But then I start getting my visions fixed on heaven. This is what it's all about. When it's all over said and done, I want to see him personally. I don't just say that. I mean it. I want to see him personally. I want to tell him for myself, thank you. I know I could have died and went to hell. I know it. Everything I did, I know I was unfit for heaven. but you saw something in me. I want to tell him. It ain't about whatever. Oh my God. I've had more homes than the law did allow it. I bought homes, sold homes. So I know you can get stuff. You don't have to be a rocket scientist. God will touch your hand and bless you. But one thing I do know, glory to God, I want to see him. And today, I'm putting away childish things. I'm tired of embarrassing God. Embarrassing you. It ain't about if you can see me, you can see me. And I love you, man. I love you. See, when you can say you love the Lord, and I mean it, don't play with it. I love the Lord. I love the Lord more than life. I love you more than this life I got. I love you, Lord. You can start biting on that. Start eating it. Start chewing on it. Except you eat of my flesh and drink of my blood, you have no part. He said that in the beginning phase. Except you eat of my flesh and drink of my blood. I said, Lord, I love you. He said, oh, taste and see that I'm good. How many feel like just like me right now? I feel like fighting this thing, man. Oh, my God, I've been done. Whoa, yeah. I want all those that are downright serious. I mean serious. Serious. Matter of fact, you're more serious than life. I want you to come up here and touch and agree with this brother. Because I feel this, man. I mean, my life is what it is, but I am serious, Pastor Simmons. I'm serious. I'm pressing towards the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. I'm touching and agreeing that I'm, oh God, what can separate me or who? What can separate me from the love of God? Nothing. Persecution, peril, distress, nothing. God will not turn his back on me because he knows. I'm serious, man. My God, I need you more than life. I need you. I need you. How many can say, I need you, Lord? I need you, man. I am straight up with this. I need the Lord.